Righto, Mark, we are back. Oh, read that book on carpentry, so you can see 220 out of 220 pages read. That's taken me a day, pretty much. I did go for slow learner trait when it comes to books. So we can dump that book now. It's only good for burning once we've read it. Basically, all I did otherwise was I shifted the stuff, the perishables, which were on the shelf down there, up into this fridge. And I had to go out to the other apartment and read a couple of books. As you can see, my geezer's been getting a bit bored, which is understandable. Good idea to cook stuff up whilst you read. It just saves time, so you take the pork chop and stick it in the oven, turn it on, and then you can watch it cook as you read your book. So you're doing like two things at once, because time is pretty important in this game. Okay, stuff our face a little bit, and basically what we need to do is we need some planks so that we can level up our carpentry. That's like number one game for us. We don't know how long the power is going to last. It could cut out at any moment, so we want our carpentry skilled up, really. Fuck, I'm hungry again. Hungry? Bored. Gotta go read some more books, newspapers, all this stuff. Magazine, why not? If you see any of these, mate, farming magazine or anything to do with like fishing or anything really, anything that teaches stuff, you want to grab it. But I mean, I can always come back here. This is our new yard. Ham, yes please. Fresh food should always be eaten first. Don't fuck around with bags of crisps and stuff, not until you have to. Plenty of fridges, plenty of fresh food. We're in the middle of town, so you've got like restaurants and stuff nearby. Sprint around where you can, because it will level up your sprinting, which will come in handy later on. Right. Oh, fuck off. Good idea to shut doors behind you, pretty much. Baseball bats, nice. Our shotgun and shotgun shells and a trowel. This guy couldn't get any luckier, I don't think. Trowel you want, mate. Any bags of seeds you see, you want to pick those up. The jars and the jar lids are quite rare unless something's changed, so grab those as well. Orange soda's very good, but I say we're in town, we're spoiled for choice, mate. We've got tons of stuff, so you know we're not in any rush there. Shotgun and shotgun shells, all good, but like I say, if you fire that off, then expect hell to come your way. Now, I don't think these are in a fridge. These are not in a fridge, so I'm going to grab all this stuff, otherwise it will eventually go off. In fact, that's one thing you can start doing. As long as there's power, you know, the fridges will keep this stuff a bit longer. I mean, really, there's no way you're going to be able to get through all of this fresh stuff, but we might as well lug some of it up to the fridge up there. Oh, fuck off. Right. If you can avoid it, not a good idea to be heavily loaded. So you can help by eating stuff because it makes you stronger by having the strong trait at the start of the game, or by not carrying around too much stuff, and also by using your backpack. I think we picked up a duffel bag, so we're going to make adjustments there as well. Forgive me, dear boy, this is a bit boring. There's a bookshop down the road, so what we're going to do is we're going to clear a path to that, and we are going to loot it for all of the beginner books which we'll want to read. We're going to get farming as soon as possible, because for me, inevitably, it comes down to farming later on in the game. Okay. Eat some food, eat some food, eat some food. Like I say, you want to have enough of these to keep you going. You always want to be well fed if you can help it. Right, who have we got? Excuse me. Be careful swinging your axe or your rolling pin or whatever it is that you have too near to these doors. If you smash those, it's going to attract a bit of attention. It's all nice out here, mate. I don't know why it's so quiet. That coffee shop there, you got a busted in window. There's a fair bit of food and what have you there. If your guy gets tired, stomping on them to finish them off is quite a energy efficient way of doing it. But if you're in a bit of a rush, then you want to finish them off with your weapon, because by stomping them you save a bit of maintenance on your weapon as well. You don't wear it out as quickly. And always be mindful of how much condition is sort of left on these things, because what you don't want is you don't want to be in amongst it and for the bastard thing to break. I always check their inventory, mainly just to make sure that they're dead. You know, if it shows that there's a corpse and there's inventory, it shows you that they're dead and that it's job done. I don't know, have they changed something here? Have they made it easier? Because the last time I played this, mate, this place was mobbed up big time. Okay. Right, we're near the bookshop, mate. I'm going to pause it there because I've got limited disk space. I'll see you in a second.